Thanks for stopping by. I'm going to be introducing you to more technical vocabulary and concepts within GUI elements to further your understanding of how we can position and size these GUI elements to scale them appropriately, put them in the right places that they need to be on the player's screen, and just general things like that. Because there's a couple of things that can trip you up with GUI elements, and this will serve more as a technical video to give you a broader understanding of positioning and scaling GUI elements inside of your Roblox game. So with that out of the way, let's jump straight into an example. All right, let's think about this for a minute. I have this text label here that just says, this is a label. And it looks pretty normal, like in terms of its position and its size of where we want it to be. So it's like a little bit under the middle of the screen. So it looks pretty okay. But that's not the whole picture here, unfortunately. If we change the size of our window, we can all of a sudden see that this text label is still showing, but it's now kind of clipped off of the screen a little bit. And if we continue scaling this down, it's not following our window's screen. So if we have a really small window, it just completely hides our label. But if we scale it back up, we can still see it's here, but it's not scaling with our screen resolution. So this is a very big problem because Roblox can be played on multiple different devices with different screen resolutions. If you're playing this on a PC, for instance, you have a pretty wide screen. But if you're playing this on a phone, it's going to be a very small screen, and if the GUI elements are not scaling in respect to the resolution of our screen, then you're not even going to be able to see the GUI elements, or the GUI elements are not going to be scaled properly. And same thing can be said with tablets and even TVs. So this is definitely a big problem, and you might wonder how the heck we're supposed to fix this. There's a pretty simple fix for this, but first I want you to understand how GUI elements are positioned and sized according to our screen's resolution. So let me just hide my GUI element for a second here. So when it comes to 2D or 3D planes, there's going to be an origin point. So in this case, if we're talking about our 3D origin, our origin point is going to be the position 000, which is like somewhere around here, which is very close to the spawn location. And when we position something inside of the 3D workspace, it's set to a position that is an offset away from the origin. So for instance, if I had a part here that had a position in the Z axis that went this way, which is like maybe about 50 studs or something, it's 50 studs away from the origin. The same thing can basically be said about our 2D GUI screen as well. So our screen has an origin as well, but because this is 2D, we're not working with three numbers, X, Y, and Z. We're working with two numbers, which is just X and Y. So X being the horizontal position, and then Y being the vertical position going up and down. And you might wonder where this position is. The position is going to be at point 00, located on the top left of the screen right here. And so the offset is basically going to be however many pixels the GUI element is away from the origin. So if I took this text label, for instance, and set this to a position of 00, 00, then it's basically going to be set to where the origin is, which is in the top left corner. But if I change this position to, let's say, 500 pixels off of the origin, then it's going to be located right here rather than being back here. So the bigger the offset is from the origin, the more it's going to go away from the origin. In this case, the origin of the X is on the left side, which is 0. And the bigger the offset is, the more the GUI element is going to go to the right. And the same thing can be said with the X value as well. So the origin 0 starts at the top. If we give it a bigger number, it's just going to keep going down, like an offset of 500 here as well. It's just going to keep going down, the bigger number you give it. So that's something important I wanted you to know about. So going back to what I was saying with offsets, I basically changed the offset position of like the X and Y of this text label to make it move away from the origin. But here's the problem with offsets is that since it's a fixed pixelated number, it's not going to automatically scale itself according to the screen's resolution of whatever device you're playing Roblox in. So what you have to do instead is modify the scale property of its position or size or whatever it is so that it will auto scale the text label to fit on whatever screen resolution you're playing a Roblox game in. So here's how we're gonna do that. If we select our text label and we go down and look at our position, there's actually four values here, not two. I'm going to explain what this means in a little bit, but what we're currently interested in is two concepts. It's our scale and our offset properties. So let's open up our position here, and there should be two tables here with X and Y. Let's open up both of these. We should see that there's a property called scale and a property called offset for both X and Y. So how we positioned the text label originally was that we changed the offset. So the offset of the X was 500 and the offset of the Y was also 500. But as you know, this isn't going to automatically scale according to the screen's resolution because offset is a fixed pixelated number from the origin. So what can we do instead? What we can do is instead of using offsets, we can use the scale property. And I want you to keep in mind that you cannot use both scale and offset at the same time. It's by choice of the developer whether you want to use scale or offset, but I highly recommend always using scale, never using offset. I've never really found an instance where I would actually use offsets. So this is coming from my recommendation to always use scale. And now I'm going to show you how to use this scale. So what we're gonna do is we're going to set these offsets back to zero. And so you have to understand with the scale property is that the units are not the same as offsets because offset is a pixel by pixel unit, but scale is just simply a number between zero and one. So our scale is currently at zero, which is on the very top left corner, but the maximum number for a scale is one, one being the very end of the screen's resolution. So for instance, if I move this to the right side, you can see that the scale of the X value is going up. And if we make it go all the way this way, it goes all the way up to a value of one, one being the maximum. So you don't see it anymore because it's on the very right side of the screen. But if we make it like 0.5, then we can see that based on its anchor point, which is at the top left corner of this text label, it's going to be in the middle of the screen. So let's move it back to the left side. We can do the same thing with the Y scale as well, just by shifting this down, and it's changing the scale to 0.5. Now let's make the scale for both X and Y 0.5. Oh, actually, maybe this can look a little bit better if it was a little more this way. Let's try to center it. There we go. So it's like somewhere around here. So we have a scale of 0.184 for the X and then 0.486 for the Y. Because this is according to its anchor point, which if you don't remember anchor points, I briefly talked about it in one of my earlier episodes, so I encourage you to watch that. But yeah, now let's see what happens when we change our Windows resolution. So I'm gonna minimize this. Now you might think, well, it looks like it's still going off screen, but if you really look at it carefully, the position of this text label is indeed scaling in accordance to the screen's resolution. But how we can really confirm that this is working is by also changing the size of this text label as well. So if we go down here to size, let's just hide our position really quick. If we go down to size and open this up, open our X and Y, we can see that we have an offset for both our X and Y, which we don't want. We don't want an offset. So what we can do instead is replace our offset. So let's change these sizes to zero. And let's change the scale to a number between zero and one. So we can make this 0.5 and we can make the Y scale 0.5 as well. And now let's position this back to somewhere alongside here in the center so we can see it fully. Now let's see what happens if we minimize the screen. As you can see, we can see the full text label on the screen. And if we scale it up and down, it's scaling the text label alongside the screen, which is very, very interesting and very, very helpful when you want a GUI element to scale alongside the screen's resolution. So now if we were playing on a phone, you can see the entire text label no matter how big or small the screen is. And so that's the difference between scale and offset. Scale is calculated based on the current screen's resolution, while offset is a fixed pixel by pixel number that you would use to create an offset position or size from its origin. I hope that made sense. So there's actually this really cool feature that Roblox has for us where if we want to test our Roblox game on a different device like a phone or an Xbox, Roblox has actually provided us device emulators so that we can actually test these games on an emulated screen as if we were playing the game on a different device. And here's where you can find it. So if we go to the top ribbon right here that says test, we can see that there's a button under emulation called device. If we click on this, we can see that there's a little pop-up that showed up that shows us a resolution that we can pick and also the specific resolution setting in mind. So if we click on the first drop-down on the left, we can see that there's a whole list of different devices that we can play on. So we can play on a phone or a tablet or a desktop or a console. In this case, let's play on the iPhone 14 Pro. We can actually see that the screen has now changed to fit the screen under our emulated device, which is our iPhone 14 Pro. And this second dropdown can show us different resolution settings. So if we want the resolution to be physically how the device would look in real life, then we would pick physical size. This is how an actual iPhone 14 would look. But if we pick actual resolution, then this shows us just the screen itself, how big this would actually be if we were to test this game on our iPhone 14 Pro device. And we can even change this to fit to window size just so that we can scale the whole thing to where we can see the resolution scaled to fit to the window so we can see everything clearly. Usually I would advise doing actual resolution. I think this would be the best setting to do for if you're just trying to test your Roblox game. And what's also interesting about this device emulation feature is that when you hit play, then you will spawn into the game playing in that device. So when you play the game, we have features that make it seem like we're playing on our iPhone 14, like this joystick that we can move around in, and this jump button, which you wouldn't find on a PC computer. So I just think this device emulation feature is really cool that Roblox has provided for us, and I definitely recommend using this feature if you're trying to test your game on multiple devices without having to own an actual device to try this game on. And finally, what I'll do is I'm going to explain a new data type that we indirectly saw when we were changing the position and size of this text label over here, called a UDim2 value. So you might be confused by that, because when we open up our text label and look at our position and size, for some reason, there's two tables filled with two values for each of these positions and sizes. So when you open these up, you see X and Y, then you see the scale and offset with all of them. You might ask what all this means, and is this a data type Roblox has made to make this possible? And yes, this is a new data type that is specifically for GUIs. So essentially the data type that the position and size use is called a UDim2, also known as a two-dimensional value. And before I explain that, I need to explain what a one-dimensional value is. So a one-dimensional value is basically this X table right here that contains two values, and this Y table that also contains two values. A one-dimensional value consists of two components, which is the scale of the axes and the offset of the axes. And so basically, when you combine one dimension of X and another one dimension of Y, you get a two-dimensional value containing two tables with two values per table, the scale and offset. So I want to reiterate this. A one-dimensional value is called a UDim, and this contains a scale and offset, which X and Y are both UDim or one-dimensional tables. And if you combine these two together with two one-dimensional tables, you get one two-dimensional value, which is the position, because it's a UDim2, and size, which is also a UDim2. So I hope that made sense. This is a GUI-specific property that you will probably use a lot, especially when you're trying to change the size of a GUI element while you're inside of the game. I'm actually going to show you an example of this using a script right now. So if we want to change the position or size of a GUI element while we're in the game, we're going to do this by using a local script, and we're going to change it using a UDim2 value. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. So on the right side, let's hit the plus sign on the text label and let's insert a local script. So let's first make reference to our text label. So we're gonna say local text equals script dot parent. And then what we're gonna do is we're going to add a wait statement here. So we're gonna say task dot wait, and we're gonna put in 5 seconds. Let's also write a print statement to know our change has been successful by saying GUI has been changed. And then down here, we're going to change the position of this text label to, let's say, be in the corner of the screen, but not entirely in the corner of the screen because we still want to be able to look at it. So let's go over here. We're going to say text.position equals, and this takes in a UDim2 value. So this is what it's going to look like when we create a new UDim2 value or two-dimensional value. We're going to say UDim2, so make sure the U and the D is capitalized, and then you have a 2 right at the end. And this is a class, so we're going to create it using a new constructor by saying dot new, and then put the open and close parentheses. And this contains 4 values. So if you remember, our 4 values is our scale and offset for the X, and then our scale and offset for the Y. So this is what it's going to look like. Right now, our X scale is 0.25. So let's make this 0.5 and we'll space this out with a comma. And then the X offset, we're not going to change the offset. So we're just gonna make this 0, another comma. Now this is going to be the Y scale. Let's change this to 0.5 as well. And finally, our last value is going to be the Y offset. But as you know, we don't like using offsets. So we're going to make this 0 as well. So let's go into the game, hit test, hit play. And we should see after about 5 seconds that our text label should change its position. So as you can see, we waited about 5 seconds and it printed down here saying the GUI has been changed and our position of the text label moved slightly further along to the right and also down. So it works basically as expected. And if we change the window, we can still see that the text is being scaled alongside our screen's resolution. So we have successfully done what we needed it to do. But we can also do this with size as well. Back to our script, we can change the size of the text as well by saying text.size equals udim2.new. And it looks like our current size is 0.5, 0.5 for both scales. So let's change this to 0.25 instead, comma, 0, because we don't want an offset, comma, and then the Y scale will also be 0.25, comma, 0. So now let's go into the game and see our final result. So let's go into the game. And there we go. As you can see, not only did our position change with the text label, but it also changed the size of it as well to not only make it go right, slightly right and slightly down, but also change the scale of it to be smaller. So the way it reduced its scale was by starting on the bottom right, and then it just scaled down like this in a diagonal direction. So that's basically how it works here with scale versus offset and also positions and sizes and UDim and UDim2 values. So I hope you learned a lot from this episode to gain more of an insight into how these GUI elements are created and scaled according to the device that you're playing on. So I hope you found this episode to be helpful. Join my Discord server, the link is in the description, and I will see you in the next episode. Take care.